Hi there, I'm DeLane Matthews, and there's an old saying that goes, tragedy ends in death, comedy ends in marriage. But sometimes marriage ends in comedy, as you'll see tonight when we take a candid look at home videos of weddings from all over the country. It's not just the brides who are blushing as we march down the aisles to discover that whatever can go wrong does. And to put things in perspective, we'll talk to experts, celebrities, and a special guest, the most married man in the world. Also tonight, we're going to see a very brave man as he proposes on the air in front of millions of people. Come over here. This is Eric Bouchard from Columbus, Ohio. And later in the show, he's going to surprise his girlfriend, Cheryl Quay, by asking her to marry him. Now, Eric and Cheryl aren't actors, so what you'll be seeing is a real live marriage proposal. Now, here we see Eric and Cheryl in an earlier rehearsal for our wedding special, but little does she know that she might very soon be planning a wedding of her own. Eric, how do you think she'll react?
I'm hoping she's gonna say yes.
Mm-hmm. We're gonna leave Eric to think this over and be back in a moment to see what happens when I and do become two of the most difficult words in the English language.
Duke, I love you very much. In a couple minutes, we'll be up there, and this will all be over. And then we can have fun.
I don't sell houses.
Okay, Jim, Judy, smile for me. That's nice. Touch on. Very sweet, very sweet. Okay, I'm just going to get a different angle, doll. You look lovely. I'm just going to... I'm fine.
I love weddings. The music, the flowers, the anxiety. And as family and friends gather together, we all get a chance to share in that time-honored tradition, weeping. You're supposed to cry at weddings, not laugh, but that is what happens when some of our couples discover that tying the knot is an exercise in being tongue-tied.
Rochelle, take this ring.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
And a sign of my life.
Love and fidelity.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
I'm sorry?
As a sign of my life and fidelity. If you repeat after me, I, James, take thee, Elizabeth. To be my lawful wedded wife.
To be lawful wedded wife.
I, Mary, take you, Douglas, for my lawful husband. To have and to hold.
I, Richard.
Take you, Melissa.
For my lawful wife.
For your minimum. Start again.
There are certain words in the marriage vows that men in particular seem to have a hard time with.
Marissa, take this ring as a sign of my love and infidelity. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Kathy, as a symbol of my love for you.
And my faithfulness to you.
And my faithfulness to you.
I give you this ring. Okay. We knew what you meant.
Okay, now, who's the bride here and who's the groom?
Repeat after me. Christine, I give myself to you to be your husband.
Christine, I give myself to you to be my husband.
I, Stephen, take you, Kim, to be my...
Hi, Catherine.
Dearly beloved, with that phrase ringing in their ears, most couples are joined in the sight of God. It's up to the priest, the minister, the rabbi, basically the person dressed unlike anyone else in the room, to set an appropriate tone.
Make time for each other. Don't live in the past, but learn from it and move on. And enjoy your sex. Your sex. Without a doubt. Enjoy sex, right? That's very important. And your successes as well. Or maybe you be successful in sex and have fun. There we go.
I'll take you, Yvette.
I'll take you, Yvette.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
I promise to be true to you.
I, George.
George.
I, Jacqueline.
Hey, Jacqueline.
We never had sex here.
Hear all prayers. We're ready. Down.
Kim.
Kim. You're right. Respect and to cherish you.
To respect and to cherish.
As my husband. As my wife.
As my wife.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
I will love you.
I will love you.
And honor you.
And honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
Now here's a bride who obviously takes her vows very seriously.
My pledge to share my life openly with you.
To speak the truth to you in love.
To speak the truth to you in love.
I wish to honor and tenderly care for you.
I wish to honor and tenderly care for you.
To cherish and encourage.
To cherish and encourage.
Your own fulfillment as an individual.
Your own fulfillment as an individual.
And our journey through life together.
In our journey through life together.
Through all the changes of our lives.
Through all the changes of our lives.
You know, having never done that big ceremony thing, I don't know, but I think that weddings in general are sort of stressful, and I don't know if probably just thinking, get me through this before I faint.
195 to tower, 195 to dock. I'm circling. Losing altitude. I think I'm going down. Mayday! I'm going down. I'm down, definitely down. Hello? Tower?
In the beginning, you created the universe and made mankind in your own likeness.
Oh, man, is it hot in here or is it just me? No, it's hot in here. It's hot. Check, please.
My biggest fear would be if I ever did get married, would not be messing up my vows or the cake falling or my friends hating their dresses, but the groom turning to me at the altar saying, you know, you're not really what I had in mind.
Aren't you excited, honey? Now we get to be together all the time.
I know a lot about weddings. I've been married 28 times, more than any other person in the world, I guess. And my first wife, Helen, we were married with horseshoe rings. I made them out of horseshoe nails. We had no money. My second wife, Marjorie, I still used the horseshoe nails, but my third wife was named Marjorie too. So I had two Marjories, one after the other. And my fourth wife was, I forget.
Stay tuned as true love stands a test of Cracker Jacks, chaos, and cockroaches.
Frankie Malone on 20.
I think if a bride is going to have a big wedding and she's going to look beautiful, I've decided that it is her obligation to find the butt ugliest dresses that she can for her bridesmaids, something that they could never use again, something that when they come down the aisle, everybody will go, look at her. Look at her behind. Will you look at that? What? It's your obligation as the bride to make all of your girlfriends look as ugly as possible.
The wedding ring represents a circle of love with no beginning and no end. And one of the first things they tell a couple during the wedding rehearsal is that it's bad luck to drop the wedding ring. So, with that in mind, let's join our couples as we ask a simple question. How hard can it be?
Don't drop the ring. Bad luck to drop the ring. Don't drop. Oh, I dropped the ring.
Oops, I dropped it. Honey, give me a hand, will you?
I can't see it. Can you see it?
I can't find it. This is some carpet.
Lovely problem. Look at the nap. We should get it for the house.
Great weave. That's really rich pile.
Swirling reds, bursts of color. It's really something.
A sign of my love.
Of course, there's nothing like a nice shag.
Oh, shag is so hard to beat. The colors, the selection.
So, what about the ring?
Oh, the ring, right.
You think anybody noticed?
Oh, look, an M&M.
Now, leave it. You don't know where it's been.
A ring, huh?
Holy water always helps.
You could use a little extra.
The rings,
oh, man,
may
really
the Lord bless these rings which you give to each other as the sign of your love.
Del.
Get them? I tied them in a knot. I did. I'm sorry. She tied them in a knot. She certainly did.
And the wedding has been technically perfect to this point, but my goodness, they've pulled out a Cracker Jack box. He's taking the ring out of the Cracker Jack box. Obviously, this is going to cost them in the artistic area. The judge is quite strict on this point. How terrible. They've gone definitely down to possibly only a bronze medal. The vows will now continue, but the damage is done. It's so unfortunate.
Dave, what symbol do you offer that you'll faithfully fulfill his promise?
The ring.
Where's the ring?
I don't have it.
Me neither.
Don't look at me.
Hey, can someone give us a hand with the ring?
Oh, here, thanks. Sorry.
Here, pass it on. Yeah, hand it over. Nice. Oh, nice one. Yeah. I gotta hand it to you, buddy. You really pulled this one off.
Well, I don't think the perfect wedding kiss would be a peck.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm proud to present...
On the other hand, I don't think you really want to see tongues at a wedding. Party. So I think probably an appropriately, I don't know, I'll have to go home and work on that one.
Honey, are you okay?
Breath and...
Dean, you may kiss the bride.
Everybody dreams of the perfect wedding, but despite the best laid plans, sometimes there's nothing you can do when that special day arrives and bad luck crosses your path.
Did you request this song?
Not me, I thought you did.
Are you kidding? It's awful. And the singer?
It's Uncle Eddie.
Your Uncle Eddie?
He's family.
He's awful.
Well, I couldn't say no.
What's with this candle, anyway?
It's bad.
Say, isn't that Uncle Eddie?
It sure is.
Okay, that's it. We blow out the candles and we are out of here. Honey, this guy's killing me. Here, would you let me?
Hey, give me a hand with this thing, huh?
Sure, no problem.
Hey, nice shoes. Yeah, thanks. I got them at this little place on Breen Street. Is that anywhere near that Italian joint? What's the name? Papa's place. Yeah. You doing okay over there?
Yeah, I got it.
So Papa's, huh?
Yeah, I go there all the time.
Nice stitching. So what'd they cost? They must have cost. They look custom made. Yeah, they are. And the pennies come in them already. They're really worth it, you know. You sure you got that side?
Yeah, no problem. Yeah, kid skin, are they? Yeah, patent leather. They're really shiny, and plus you can see up people's legs and stuff.
Come on, are you going to do this with me or what?
Yeah, let's do it.
It's hard to walk like this, huh?
Yeah.
The groom breaks a glass, Zecher le Chorban, in symbolic recognition that even at a time of personal joy, we are not unmindful of the history of our people.
Hurry.
Wow.
This couple may get a sign from above they're not looking for.
To give us words, both kind and loving, and hearts always ready to ask for forgiveness and always ready to forgive. Dear God, we are one before you. Uh-oh. Your love is so unique, different than any other. You're both good.
Oh, my goodness. You're going to do that for the next 10 minutes. Go ahead.
And of course, at all weddings, there's the uninvited guest.
Hey, is this your Rosenberg wedding? I just love weddings. The music, the flowers, the buffets. Can't wait. Oh, better find my seat. Is this the bride's side or the... Oh, Uncle Eddie, how's it going, big guy? Can I squeeze by? Excuse me, pardon me. Whoa, hey, you!
Even the bride's dress isn't safe from attack.
For continued rain in the north and central regions, with gusting winds accompanied by possible severe updrafts. This rather inclement period seems to be...
And down the stretch they come. Happy husband leads by a nose over flailing veil. Then it's two lengths back to maid of honor. Father of the bride will not finish. He's nowhere. With an eighth left, it's happy husband still the lead. But here comes flailing veil. It's happy husband. Flailing veil. Happy husband. In at the wire. It's happy husband by a nose. Flailing veil to place a maid of honor to show.
Getting married on Valentine's Day might seem like a romantic idea, but might not be the best time of year for an outdoor wedding.
Here's going to be a giant tent, Omar's tent, where people can choose to play tennis or have hors d'oeuvres at their leisure. Baseball probably won't be going. I'm joking. It's not going to rain. It's not going to rain.
Might want to take a picture of that. This is what we call a storm cloud, ladies and gentlemen.
Good sport.
supposed to be sunny. By all means, the weatherman all week long says it's going to be sunny on Sunday. Why the rain? Maybe it's good luck. We hope so.
It's starting to come down, but it'll pass. Don't worry. It'll pass.
It's raining. There's probably a lot of people you want to kill right now, but we're doing fine. I love you. That's all that matters. And when you look back at this someday, you're going to hysterically laugh.
It snowed.
You know, we're sorry to everybody. You'll always remember this. I want to thank everybody for getting out orderly and listening to me. Usually people don't. Everything's going to be okay.
You're a regular hero.
We got the white wedding.
They saved the challah. Janine, come see your
heart-shaped
challah.
Give her a kiss, Mom.
Look, Janine, your challah saved. It's gorgeous. You have to come down and cut it.
All right.
We don't want it to get wet.
I'm going to have to leave.
It's going
to
be okay.
Come upstairs here, and we'll put on some makeup.
Let's help her down.
Okay, come on.
All right, come here. Let me give you a kiss.
I love you.
Paulette was my 14th wife, and she was a topless dancer in Las Vegas. And
when we come back, the rise and fall of wedding cakes. Back.
You think?
This is my 8th wedding. I've been married so many times, I've got rice marks in my face.
Adults who suffer from wedding day jitters. For young children, weddings are often a confusing place to be.
Okay, all I have to do is make it up these steps, no problem, and I just, whoa! Those are huge steps. Okay, I'm getting up, I'm fine, I can do it. Okay, now I just have to come over here and,
Matthew, turn around.
Over there? Oh, and go back. Okay, no problem. I've been there before. I usually fall right around here. This is fun. Hi, everybody. No thanks. Michael, who are you?
If you're a kid and you go to a wedding, you should always bring your own pillow in case you want to take a nap during it or something. And there's a sheet on the floor, too, so it's like your whole bed's here. Oh, hi, Mom. You want your pillow back? Oh, we're going the other way? Is there food the other way? Going for a walk, okay.
Bye. Left, right, whoops, drop the book and the pillow.
I can't see. I can't see. I can't see. Oh, now I can see.
What is it we're supposed to do?
I don't know. Who are these people?
I don't know. I don't like the looks of this.
Just stay on this side of the carpet.
If anybody comes near me, I'm gonna run.
I'll be right behind you.
Okay, let's book it. I'm out of here.
Absolutely.
Well, hey, little lady, can I hold your hand?
No.
Oh, come on, darling, just for a second.
No.
Oh, don't play hard to get with me. Come on.
No.
Let you play with my Power Ranger.
No.
Okay, my final offer, Power Ranger, Nintendo, and Dad's Mercedes. She wants me.
Perfect, perfect. Now I pull back very dramatically, get a nice shot of the whole family. This is great.
The kid. Yeah, you. Could you not... just look forward. Stop looking at the camera. I'm trying to get a shot here. Okay, now... Sonny, could you, Babe, you want a buck? Look, here's a buck. Come here.
And welcome back to Championship Wrestling. A tough battle tonight between Sammy and Patty. I haven't seen a struggle like this in years. Oh, and Patty takes down Sammy with a vicious bear hug. My, my. And it looks as though the ref is coming in here to clean things up a little. And, but the fans are going wild. Just listen to them. Now back to the action. It's Sammy. He's got a double palm back hold on her. It's a struggle out there all the way. And, oh, a power throw. Oh, my, that's gotta hurt.
John, hold me.
Catherine, my darling.
How I've dreamt of this moment.
If only it could last forever.
Promise me you'll never, never let me go.
Destiny has brought us together. Nothing can separate us now.
Mom!
Dad!
Mom says I have to go now.
Bogus!
First dance for the bride and groom is supposed to be a memory that lasts a lifetime. However, many prospective newlyweds get nervous about facing the world with four left feet, so they seek professional help.
Brides and grooms should take dance lessons so that they're more comfortable the day of their wedding. They've got so many other things to worry about, and for many people that haven't danced before, it's a frightening experience, so it just makes that first dance so much easier for them. The man often has never danced before. It's his first time in his life where he's had to dance. So he starts thinking, gee, I'm going to have all my family and friends staring at me. It might be a good idea to have a clue as to what I'm going to do. What I always suggest is just get out and do what you know and move comfortably. Often comes in to update, maybe catch up on what the latest steps are or some of the new dances that came out. And we find that they learn probably more quickly than any other group.
Thank you. great. My dad lost his tux. I've seen him do this before, honey. I think he wants to dance with you. Yes, it's monogrammed. Everybody get into diapers and dance with my dad. We had to have an open bar. Perfect planning. Nice move, Dad. Oh, boy. I'm never getting married again. This is it.
It's important for partners, when they go to dance with each other, that they give their attention to each other. Dancing is a form of communication, and they're sharing, and it's something that, it's impolite to not give your attention to your partner.
Okay, honey, now if you lose your balance, just grab my hand, okay?
My hand!
Fails and you weren't able to take instruction and learn properly, best thing to do is just get out there and improvise.
Buttercream. A wedding cake can be a work of art. When Queen Elizabeth married Prince Philip, their cake was adorned with musical cupids. The cake weighed 500 pounds and it stood 9 feet high. Today, the average wedding cake costs anywhere between $500 and $1,500. And like marriage itself, each wedding cake has its own special destiny.
I guess smashing is traditional, but I've never understood the smashing cake in your face thing. What is that? I have no idea. You might as well just throw a piece of pie and some. I mean, why would you want to do that? You get it all over your dress and everything. It's horrible.
The origin of cake decorating started in the ancient Roman aristocrat wedding marriages and celebrations. And of course, do you know, the bride and groom cut the cake because that would mean plenty, fertility, and happiness. Nowadays, they simplified it, and now they feed it to each other. That's so much better. Disaster in any of my experience making wedding cake. The table collapsed and the cake went all over the floor. And then they had to go out and buy Twinkies to serve to the reception.
sure do like cake, and I'm gonna take a bite of this right now.
You remember Eric? The guy is gonna ask his girlfriend to marry him right here at the wedding reception, live in front of millions of people. Well, time's running out, Eric. Stay tuned for his big moment.
We began to joke that if we were still dating in 1995, we would get married. Time flies, you know, when you're having fun, and here we are in 1995, and it's pretty much now or never.
Okay, people, now bring it in at table, people, come in. Okay, table number three, come in. It's okay over there, put it next to table number one. Table three, watch the bump. Okay, fine, everybody, watch the bump. And Justin, watch the bump. No problem. Come on, people, busboy people, I'm cleaning up. It's clean pastries, everybody off the floors, no problem. We're having fun. There's dancing and food on the floors, no problem. Everybody, let's set up here. Okay, everybody, help me. That's a chance, would be good.
The bouquet toss is one of the most eagerly awaited moments of the reception. As the unmarried women gather together in a friendly group, hopes of future success tend to bring out the best and the worst.
I didn't have a bouquet toss at my wedding because I just was like, I think it's so retarded. I hate it. I hate standing. All right, everybody get together, all you single girls, and everybody pushes you over there, and you're just standing there going, this is really great. I feel like such an idiot. I don't want to catch this stupid thing.
The sweet little girl that lives down the street. A pure face square, but I'm face sweet. You can see her every day scrolling up and down the way. Looking so pretty, and this is what I think. She got it. Oh, baby, she's got it. Baby, she's got it. I can't do without her. Baby, blue eyes, long black hair. But she knows where she's got it. Oh, baby, she's got it.
Hysterical to watch at weddings these demurely dressed women in their pearls and their taffeta gowns fighting like hyenas. It's so funny because you know their dates are standing back watching this going, whoa, a little too needy, a little too clingy. The thing that I always find very crass at weddings is, and it's a little chauvinistic, is the bride throws her bouquet of flowers to the other women, and whoever catches that is the next to be married. The groom, however, takes her garter belt, and I think that's so incredibly tacky that, I mean, why doesn't he flip his boutonniere? No, he hikes up her skirt, he takes off a piece of her underwear, and he flips it to these guys over there. I mean, that's not that much different than what would happen at a stag party. You know, it's like taking a pasty. Here, there you go, guys, here you go.
Ready, set, go, man, go. I got a gal that I love so well. Ready, I'm ready.
roll, all the fat top cats, and I was done with me dogs. I had a father Jim to the top hop bone. The dogs are really tough and the cats are going wild. The music really fit my teeth the best style.
No, I ain't giving nobody my wife's garter. Are you crazy?
I had to follow Jim to the top hot bone. The dogs really jump and the cats are going wild.
I keep it for myself.
The music really fit my teeth, the crazy style. Rock and roll.
Here's Eric enjoying his last few moments as a free man.
If Cheryl says no, I have no idea what she's going to do. I'm pretty confident that she's going to say yes.
And now the moment we've all been waiting for. Eric?
Cheryl, I've waited 7 years to ask you this. I love you. I want to spend the rest of my life with you. Will you be my wife? Well?
We'll be right back.
If I say too much, I know I'm gonna cry, so I love you too. And I know I was skeptical at first, but I know now that I wish you guys the best of luck, and I love you too, Jeanette.
Thank you. You know, after watching all these videos, I'm surprised this wedding turned out so well. I'm DeLane Matthews. Thanks for watching.
If you have a funny wedding home video that you'd like to see in our next program, send a copy to Here Comes the Bride, River Road, Inc., 7336 Santa Monica Boulevard, Box 564, Hollywood, California, 90046. Tapes become property of River Road, Inc. and will not be returned. Thank you.
the serious, power-packing, teeth-clenching, boot-kicking action of Chuck Norris. 5 million missing bucks leads him into a one-man mission of unbelievable danger. Tonight, he can trust no one. An all-new Walker Texas Ranger. Next. This is CBS.